Hi friends, welcome back to React.js Zero to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about how to handle events in React. In this video, I'm going to explain about states in React. Let's start. In the last video, I have created a variable called count, and I tried to increase that count on clicking a button. But I have shown it was actually getting increased, but it was not reflected in the UI. The reason for that is, for something to reflect in the UI, React needs to re-render the UI. Otherwise, it will not reflect. We have states in React to achieve that. State is a built-in React object that is used to contain data or information about the component. A component state can change over time, and whenever it changes, the component re-renders. So we need to keep the count in a state, and when we change the value of the count, the component re-renders, and so we can see the updated value in the UI. Let me show that. We know that functional components are stateless components. Before the introduction of hooks, there were no options to maintain the state in the functional components. And so, for now, let me explain this in a class component. But soon after we learn about hooks, we are going to see how we can manage the state in functional components. I have created this new React application, in which I have created a class component and copied some codes from previous application to replicate the scenario I have explained. So you can see, when I click this button, the count is actually getting increased, but it is not reflecting in the UI. So let's use state here. And to maintain state in class component, we need a constructor. First line inside constructor should be a call to super. This is just oops concept. Okay, now inside the constructor, I can create a state. We need to use this.state, which is an object. Let me have the count inside, like this. Please note that in class component, we need to use this dot to access the variables and functions. Now I can use this state wherever needed. And this count variable is not needed. So here, instead of showing the old count variable, I can show the count from the state, like this. And inside the increment function, for displaying in the console, I can use it like this.state.count. But for changing the count, I cannot use it like this, because we should not mutate the state directly. If we do it like that, it will not re-render, and so it will not work. So how can we do that? We have a setState function, which we can use to mutate the state. So here, instead of this, I can use this.setState of, I can use this object. Where instead of 0, I can use this.state.count plus 1. Now we can see it is working. This is how we can use state. Okay, let me show you this. The initial state is 0. And when I click the button once, the count is changed to 1 and it is replacing the count in the state. And so we may expect to be 1 here also. But it is not. We can see that in the console. Initially, it is 0. When I click the button, we can see it is changed to 1 here. But in console, it is still 0. If I click the button again, it is changed to 2 in the UI. But in the console, it is 1. Why it is showing the previous state? That is because setState function is asynchronous. If I move this code inside a set timeout, that means inside an asynchronous block. Now we can see it is same as the UI. Hope you understood about states in React. Okay, you can try this task. You can create 3 buttons and 1 counter. When you click the first button, it should increase the counter. And when you click the second button, it should decrease the counter. And when you click the third button, it should reset back to 0. Try this. If you need the solution code, you can take it from this GitHub repo. The link is available in the description. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.